Kia ora whānau. With my recent announcement of joining the Limelight SMP, link in the description, I thought I'd go down memory lane of my first ever SMP and show you around. So to start off, we'll have a tour of my base and builds. This tower with the nether portal was the first thing I built, and I'll insert an image of my inspiration here, here, and here. So I guess, yeah, I'll just fly and show you what it looks like from afar. So you can really see the inspiration in that one, and we will just head on down to the big lotus where each petal is something different and built by me and Trin. This first one here I think is ruins that Trent built. Looks pretty cool. Yeah. And just head around the path. And oh, kitty. Little Satan. I think I made a cat farm at some stage. I'm 90% sure I did. This next petal is a sword in the stone, also built by Trent. As you carry on, this is the first one that I built on. It was from a YouTube tutorial, and I also made some custom trees, which is sort of like my first attempt at them. This next one was a jungle theme with Mr. Panderson and just Panda. It was a mission to get them here. There's supposed to be like a temple and custom jungle trees. I was really into my custom trees at this point. Next one is like a nether theme. It was heavily inspired off like, you know, a nether crack, like breaking through the overworld and sort of seeping in and taking over. We have a villain being the flower pot men, if you're Australian or Kiwi, shout out. I think Levi did those. Here we have what was going to be a desert but turned into an oasis with pool floaties inspired by Mumbo's Pacifica. Yeah. With a lot of the coral and spooky skeleton horses that pop up everywhere. I don't know, they scare me. I always get the skeleton horse riders whenever I see them. This was, I'm not sure where that zombie is. B-dubs inspired with a custom tree. Ugh. It always rains. Let's go hop in a bed in here and get rid of this awful weather. So this B-dubs starter build house is from his tutorial. I really like Hermitcraft, so you'll see a lot of those. Oh, that little zombie. I don't know where he is, but we'll find him. Maybe. He's somewhere under there. And this is a Kelpie the Fox. Hey, little kitty. You aren't named. Oh, that's okay. Kelpie the Fox tutorial. This is when I really started getting into cottagecore thing, like, style. You'll see a lot of Kelpie's tutorials in a little village later on. And yeah, I made these glass lotuses and this lotuses in the center. This, yeah. We have Lawrence. I started watching Drag Race UK, so the cat started being named after drag queens. That's Lawrence Cheney. yeah, just cute little fountains in the middle here, and you'll see how we get in and out of the inside of the lotus. There's all these like columns, water columns, and I haven't been on the server in a really long time, so I didn't know how where everything was. I was like, oh, a little lost here. Go as far down, you can see some farms. None of my farms are efficient. They're just there. They're just, you know, we tried. That's the cat farm but also it was a villager farm, I believe, and I just ended up with a lot of cats. This is my automatic storage system. I don't remember what the tutorial was, but I really love this, and I think I'm gonna build it again in the next server, the next SMP on Limelight. More zombies, more cats, just everywhere. Yes, as you can see, it's still sorting items. I have no idea what. Back we go. If I can get up. We just head back through. It just organized everything like really neatly. It didn't have to be like one item per double chest. It was really great. We'll head up. Try and find my way to the other farms. I had a very small villager trading. 90% sure that's what produced all the cats. More little zombies. I'm trying to see if I can find out where it is, but no. Just did little trades. Nothing's pretty here, but that's alright because it was underground, so no one would see it except for me. I was the only one using these farms. Oh, down we go again. As you can tell, I have no idea which column goes up, which one goes down. And let's see if we can... Oh, nope, we missed it. We'll get there eventually. We'll just have another wander through this really... with a nice little walkway. Hopefully we can get to the bees. And, oh, yeah, this is the bee farm. And flower farm. As you can see, it's not efficient, but I wanted the bees to have open space. And then, oh, we got a little trapdoor down to my other inefficient farms. Well, this honeycomb and honey bottles that I never used. And I started putting the glazed terracotta arrows to figure out where was up and down. So we'll head into my more inefficient farms. More zombies, more cats. They're just everywhere at this point. Yeah, super inefficient. I wanted, what's the glow mushroom called? I don't know. But it was just, it wasn't the greatest. So here's the outside. We got some skeletons. More cats, it's bag of chips. Trent built this tree root with a really cool beehive made out of bee nests. It was all like a lot of armor stand work. I really hate the honey sound, which is pretty cool. And oh, another, oh god. I'm terrified lightning's gonna strike them and like, zombies, skelly zombies. And then we'll just fly around this little path that I made, and we'll head over to the village. We won't really talk about that. All of these houses are from Kelpie the Fox tutorials. I'll put a link in the description to their YouTube channel. So really got me into the cottagecore vibe, which will be in a lot of my builds. Hey old skin. Some signs. Hello Milo, I was catching up on your streams last night. This place looks amazing. Keep up the good work, friend Levi. And Crystal Beth. So Trent was doing a lot of the arm statue work. It's a little greenhouse. and I was watching a lot of Hermitcraft. So with Impulse, just heading into, I think, this wizard tower. Up we go. More zombies. I don't know where it is. I don't know where they are. So he's got like the new spyglass because this came out in like 1.17. 1.17 was the latest on this one. We have Turnipede from Howl's Moving Castle sitting in the garden. Oh. And this is a little hobbit inn. I'm not sure if they're pointing in or trying to hold themselves up at this point. But this is Zedef pouring his concoctions. And we have Mumbo, Scar, and Green from Hermitcraft discussing a potato. And we have B-dubs, Tango, Corellis vomiting on the floor. They're just having a freak out. This is really well done. I love that vomit. And then the OG crew, Levi, Trent, and I, and our old skins as well. It's a bit, it's very nostalgic. This inn wasn't finished, unfortunately. I think there was going to be a kitchen and some rooms, and I just never finished it. Archie! Doesn't look like Archie though. Yeah, we've got more hermits in the library. I love how these just like random heads on armor stands. Oh dear. And we have Zombie Cleo and False, more hermits hanging around. This is a bakery, was supposed to be a bakery. Yeah, oh, can we see the face? We'll try and back up a little. Oh, kind of, not really. We have a little False, no, not False, Stress Monster. The Stress Monster, so tiny. Hanging out in the pond and unfinished, where a lot of this is unfinished. Definitely named two of these axolotls. Just hop in. Yeah, we got Clarence and Ernest. Clarence and Ernest. Yeah. Ooh, and time skipped. Witch's Cottage from Kelpie again. Another tower. This one maybe had like a wizard. I don't know. I don't really remember what was going on around here. That was supposed to be a dwarven mountain, but yeah, so I wanted to thank you for coming along. I will do another part and show you the rest of the builds on the server, like Trent's base, Levi's, all the communal areas, and I look forward to hanging out on the Limelight SMP. Bye!